Today we're going to show you how to make a fire water balloon. Doesn't that sound weird? All you're going to need for this experiment is a funnel, a glass of water, a lighter, some balloons, and a candle. The first step is to carefully take your lighter and light your candle. Make sure that you have a parent or another adult with you when you're conducting this experiment. The next step is to blow up a balloon, carefully tie off the end to make sure no air escapes, and hold the balloon carefully just above the tip of the flame. As you lower it down, you'll see that the heat from the flame pops the balloon, and the force of that air escaping actually blows the candle out. So how do we stop this from happening? Well, here's the trick. Take the funnel, place it inside the neck of the balloon, and fill up the balloon with water. Not too much, just enough to fill up the balloon as it is. Once you've put the water into the balloon, very carefully, blow the rest of the balloon up until it's about the same size as the first balloon. Then, once again, carefully tie off the end of the balloon to make sure none of the air or the water escapes. Once you've done that, you're ready to proceed with the experiment. Once again, very carefully, light the candle. Place it on the counter. Take your balloon and hold it the same distance away from the candle. You'll find that you're able to get much, much closer to the flame, and still nothing happens. The reason this happens is because the water inside the balloon is conducting the heat away from the surface. This means that it doesn't pop. You can very slowly and carefully move the balloon around above the flame, and you'll find that it still doesn't pop. And that's because the water moves with the surface of the balloon. You'll find that you're able to hold the balloon above the candle for a really, really long time, and absolutely nothing happens. And there you have it. That's how you make your very own fire water balloon at home. Today we're going to show you a non-popping balloon. Now this is a really fun experiment that you might have seen before. All you're going to need is a roll of sellotape, a skewer, and a balloon. All you need to do is stretch out the balloon a little bit, and then blow it up just as you would normally. Once you've blown it up, very carefully tie one end off, or have a parent do it for you. Make sure it's completely sealed, then take a small piece of tape and fix it to one side of the balloon. Stick it down nice and firmly, then turn the balloon around and stick a piece of tape onto the opposite side. This will mean that you have a piece of sellotape on either side of the balloon. Then take your skewer and very carefully, very slowly, push the skewer through the balloon. You might want to try twisting it slightly just as you do this. You'll see that the skewer goes all the way through the balloon without the balloon popping. This is because the surface of the balloon is made of rubber, which tends to cling very tightly. There's already surface tension in the balloon because you've blown it up. And so when you push the skewer through the side, the rubber clings and sticks to the outside of the skewer, meaning air is not able to escape. And there you have it, that's how you make a non-popping balloon. Today we're going to show you how you can fill up a balloon with a chemical reaction. What you're going to need to do this experiment is 1 tablespoon of baking soda, 1/4 cup of vinegar, some paper, a bottle and a balloon. First of all, you need to take your paper and roll it up into a cone shape. There we go. Easy peasy. So, just put it into the top of your balloon, like so, and pour in the baking soda. Then, very carefully, remove the cone from the top of the balloon and stretch the neck over the top of the bottle. Make sure you're very careful when you do this. Then take the other end of the balloon and tip it upside down. This will pour the baking soda into the bottle,
and you'll see the balloons start to fill up instantly. This is because the baking soda is mixing with the vinegar and creating a gas called carbon dioxide, which fills up the balloon. And there you have it, your balloon filled with nothing but a chemical reaction. This is a really fun way to blow up your balloons. So next time you have a party at your house or you have a birthday, maybe you could blow up all your balloons this way. Please do share this video with your friends, comment in the box below, and make sure that you tell everyone about how much fun you had doing the experiment. Today we're going to show you the balloon trick. You're going to need a balloon and some pins, as well as a flat surface. As you know, if you push a pin against a balloon, it pops. It's really loud and it can scare people. But what if you used lots of pins? In this case, we've emptied out a whole box of pins onto our table. You'll need to take a little time and make sure that each of the pin points is pointing upwards. It's best to ask an adult to help you with this. Make sure that they're grouped closely together. Then take your balloon and nothing happens. Try pushing down again and you'll see that nothing happens. This is actually for a very simple reason. When you push a pin against a balloon, one single sharp pinpoint creates a lot of pressure in one area, which pierces the rubber and pops the balloon. However, lots of pinpoints spreads the pressure against lots of different points, meaning there isn't much pressure in one single place, meaning it's very, very difficult to pierce the balloon. And there you have it. That's how you can perform the balloon trick.